I want to always to have a little bit of feel and bubble to my horse so that if something happens, I want him to go away from me, not into me, right? So, and that's just something to be aware of as you're working and going. I got that back cinch done up a lot more now. I'm gonna chase his front end off of me right there. Just want to keep him going around that same direction every time he's kind of traveling where I want him to go. I'm just being, so that's pretty good. He's obviously, if we were to step on this horse right now, we'd have to turn into a bronc rider. So we're going to put him through a little bit of a driving routine, and I'll show you how this is going to kind of help to get him softened down and thinking, so then I can get on his back. Come around this side, hook it in. So this is where you can kind of get in a little bit of a bind. I'm gonna kind of manipulate this horse around so you can see a little better. Here we go. So I wanna make sure all this back behind me isn't going to cause me a wreck, and I'm not going to get caught up in it when I throw this rope over his butt. So this colt here, when I throw this rope over his butt, he's going to try to leave. Except I'm not going to let him. He's had these lines on before. This isn't his first time. Okay? So I'm going to stop him. Because I don't want him to feel the line go over and him just freak out and check out and go to nature. So if this was the first time driving him, I'd step out of the way here and I'd throw the line over and I'd let him line out and go around. He's been drove before. He knows what's going to happen. He knows how to steer. He's further along than that last horse we did. He just isn't quite as good minded and he wants to do things his way. So when I throw it over, he's going to try to leave and I'm not going to let him. I'm going to make him think, because he's going to be trapped by these lines, so he's got to turn his brain on and think, not just check out. Then I'll pull on the other end and I'll wait on that horse and I'll wait until he turns, okay? And then we'll quit. We're standing there. I'll pull on that other side and I'll pull and I'll pull and I'll pull, and then he turns. And then I'll do the other side and I'll pull on it and I'll pull on it, and he'll give way. Oh, and his hip came over too. Now, I'll do one side, the other side, one side, and I'll keep switching until that horse starts to come back. And he started to come back. Now, on this colt's perspective, he's letting me in there good. So pretty much we're ready to get on him. Showed me all the signs. So the biggest thing when I step on this colt, because he's just naturally wants to be tight with everything we are doing today, is I've got to be loose when I get on him. I don't want to get on him and freeze. I want to get on him and move just like I am here. I've got high energy right here on the ground. I got high energy. I'm not trying to trick this horse. I'm just getting on his back. It's not a big deal. He wanted to bolt. I didn't want